Ladies and gentlemen, this next contest is in the Abu Dhabi Warriors middleweight division. Please welcome your first fighter, making his way to the blue corner, representing Germany, Jonas Billstein.
And now Jonas Billstein making his way. Making his way into the ring as we move forward with the Road to Abu Dhabi tournament. One of these men will become a semifinalist and will move on to Abu Dhabi in the middleweight division. Billstein, fighting out of Germany, 25 years old, fighting under Max Schmidt and Mike Kuprios, 16 wins, 5 defeats on the record.
And ladies and gentlemen, your second fighter making his way to the red corner, representing Russia, Sergei Martynov.
Now Sergei Martynov, 24-year-old fighter, makes his way in to the IRMAX Arena. Cornering him would be the 1FC middleweight champion, Vitaly Big Dash, with a record of 6-1. This is a really tough young fighter and a perfect candidate to be in this tournament. You're not seeing a whole lot of veteran presence in the tournament. You're seeing guys that are up and coming, guys that are future champions, future stars in this sport. Those are the guys that are getting hand-picked to be in the Road to Abu Dhabi tournament. Of course, getting talent from all over the world, all over the globe, scouring for talent has been the staff here at Abu Dhabi Warriors. And of course, keep your eyes on AbuDhabi-Warriors.com. Remember, folks, it'll be just 2 weeks from today that we will be in Malaysia with our next Road to Abu Dhabi event. Certainly don't want to miss that one. October 8th, save the date. Don't want to miss it. It'll also be available on Abu Dhabi Warriors and EliteBoxing.com. Very, very busy year for us here at Abu Dhabi Warriors. A lot of great events setting up another huge mega card in Abu Dhabi. Martynov is inside the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing these two Abu Dhabi Warriors once again. The fighter standing in the blue corner, he is 25 years of age. He weighed in at 84 kilograms. He has a fight record of 16 wins with 5 losses. He represents Germany. He is Jonas Billstein. And standing across the ring in the red corner, this fighter is 24 years of age. He weighed in at 84 kilograms. He has a fight record of 6 wins with a 1 loss. He represents Russia. He is Sergei Martynov.
And here we go. Time to keep things moving here as you take a look at the tail of the tape. The height advantage will go to Billstein as well as the experience. Both fighters very, very similar in age, 25 and 24. Will the experience make a difference? Of course, Martynov coming out of the very successful, very disciplined Akhmat Fight Club. And back to battle we go. Getting right back to it. We welcome Grant Waterman back to the headset, pulling double duty tonight, and it is Martynov in the white and in the gray, Billstein. Talking about the experience difference here, when you take a look at the records, 16-5, that's 21 fights for Billstein, only 7 fights for Martynov. A little bit of a difference.
There's a difference, but you know, the matchmakers do their research. Billstein's got a great ground game, and he's a very, very good wrestler. So as I was thinking that, let's see. Someone's grabbing the ropes there. Come on, ref. But let's see if the Russian, who all of the Russians, I don't know one Russian who hasn't got a great wrestling pedigree.
No, it just kind of comes with the territory, and either that or the combat sambo and just some of these disciplines that kind of come natural for them. And right into the corner is Martynov.
But you'll see Billstein's sort of game plan, I feel. He fights in a way that his strikes are there to set up a takedown. So it's going to be an interesting one, because Sergei Martynov there has he's pushed the fight back to his feet. They're not really doing much in the corner there, but I think Martynov is going to outstrike Billstein if they say stood up.
Yeah. And there we go. Blow that on out of there.
Yeah, he hadn't paid his rent, so he had to go. Now, you watch, again, it's intriguing, isn't it? Every fight tonight has been sort of different and unique in its own way.
Well, you know what you're going to get here from the middleweights, and that's a whole lot of power. These guys are both very well built. They have the power, they have the pedigree, and they have the good record. So, like I said before, both men are very, very deserving of this opportunity. Grabbing onto the ropes on two different occasions, and now he gets the takedown.
You see, what I like there, you know, Martynov was, you know, blatantly breaking the rules to resist the takedown, but Billstein didn't sort of start bumping his gums at the referee. He just carried on doing what he was doing.
He didn't stop at all, and here he goes, flattening out Martynov. Yeah. Taking that top position, now what can he do with it?
Yeah,
great defense on the bottom by Martynov, not allowing Billstein to really posture up and do any sort of damage from here.
But man, that's an uncomfortable position to be in. If somebody's mounted you and they've got those suits and hooks into your shins, it stops you bridging. Although,
sneaking the shots in here is Billstein. Referee watching very closely.
Wearing him down. You can see Martynov trying to unhook his legs so that he can bridge. Billstein coming into side control. Maybe he's going to look for a Kimura or an arm triangle.
Of course, we welcome everybody tuning in. If you just joined us, EliteBoxing.tv and AbuDhabi-Warriors.com, carrying the fights here this evening from Sofia, Bulgaria, the Armex Arena, largest arena in Bulgaria. And we're going to go ahead and a little bit of a break there just to get the mouthpiece back in. Martynov, very, very attentive.
Yes. Official. Yes.
It's a minute left.
Maybe rinse it off next time, though.
That is. Less than a minute left in this 3 5-minute round affair. These two men have got tied up here. They get underneath the ropes, and we're going to keep them in the same position.
Referee's going to reset them.
Right back into it. The crowd not really feeling this too much. Not a whole lot of action, a lot of stalling right now, and just kind of jockeying for position on the ground.
I'm not sure what Billstein's, Billstein's obviously, his plan is to get his opponent on the ground and control him. But is he, this isn't a jiu-jitsu match, passing guard and going here,
he hasn't really given himself a chance to really land any big shots. You got to believe he might just be trying to pass guard and try to work a submission, because he really hasn't done much with the ground and pound. It doesn't seem too interested in doing so. He ends in side control, and that is going to be the end of round number one. And Billstein, just from having his opponent on the ground, probably took that round.
Yep. Yeah, I'm sure
that wasn't a real pretty round, but get that one out of the way.
But, it's a three-round fight. He's worn his opponent out. Martynov will be feeling the energy loss from having his opponent lay on top of him like that and control him. But there was nothing there that was pushing the fight towards a finish, was there?
No, there certainly wasn't. We'll take a little bit
of. You see the replay there, Billstein. It looked like he was trying to take the back of Martynov. There's that takedown resistance.
Well, when you look at his record, he does have quite a few submission victories, so that seems to be his preferred method of getting the W. So Billstein's going after it, but the thing is, Martynov's not giving up much. Very, very durable fighter, well disciplined.
But, you know, we could see, I've moaned about a lot of Americans in the past. Americans slate the English, or they have done for their poor wrestling. But I always slate the...
This is not particularly political. This is turning ugly.
It frustrates me. If ever I watch an MMA fighter who's a great wrestler and takes his opponent down and controls him and can't finish him, it's just frustrating to watch.
Of course it is. I agree with you on that. And here we go. Moving in there with the jab is Billstein. Only a matter of time until he shoots in. And there we go. Right on cue.
You see, if Billstein's got this sort of... I'm saying he's a one-trick pony, but if his game plan is just going to be continuous, close the gap, throw a few little feints to close the gap to take his opponent down, when that stops working, what happens then?
Very good question. We may see that question answered.
Like here, I'd like to see his switch stance, but when he was orthodox, you know, slamming some low kicks.
He's not really committing to any of his strikes. He's throwing a few out there, but not really following through with it, not really putting together any sort of combinations. He just wants to close the gap and get the takedown at this point. And, you know, his record is 16-5, proves that he can do that, but it's not going to get him a whole lot of callbacks in this industry.
He can only do it if his opponent lets him. So a fighter like this is all about matchups.
Wait for his cue, and there it is.
Exactly. Yep.
He's going to try to drag down his opponent. If he can continue to move forward, he is going to get credit for that takedown, and he will. Nice takedown there.
Yeah, again, MMA scoring, I think a lot of judges put too much weight on takedowns. You know, if you're going to take a fight, if you're doing something effective, what you should be doing is taking a fight towards a finish somehow, either by submission or strikes.
So what you're saying is just getting a takedown just to get a takedown shouldn't really count for anything.
Yeah, I mean, if you get a takedown and end up in your opponent's guard, who's got the advantage? Unless you start raining down some serious strikes.
And he's going to try to backpack him. Right, Once again, he grabs onto the ropes. Yep. Martynov has done that. I believe that'll be his third time.
He's starting to grab it again.
And at some point, the referee is going to have to take a point, or he's going to have to do something in this situation because he has a grip on the rope. And I'm saying it loud enough that hopefully the referee's hearing it.
Yeah, you're right. It should knock his hand away and make sure he's aware that the referee's on top of it. I wouldn't be too critical about the refereeing tonight because overall, it's been pretty good.
It's been pretty solid, but how many times until you call a warning or until you do take a point?
Well,
in your philosophy, you've been around the block once or twice.
Yeah, well, I mean, if it's preventing a takedown, like that second time there, I would have warned him there. And said, I would have made it clear that if he does it again, he's getting a point taken off. One thing I've always done is if two fighters are on the ground and one fighter uses the cage or the ring ropes to help himself get back to his feet, I'll stop the fight and put them back down on the ground.
Yeah.
Because that is unacceptable.
Ooh, wow. Lands the knee on that one.
He's trying to go around the back there. Something I haven't seen for a while. Somebody jump up, get their hooks in and apply a rear naked choke from a standing position. That's always entertaining.
Indeed. Billstein, he wants to tap out his opponent. He's very, very much committed to it. That being said, he's stuck him with a few jabs and he's shown us a little bit more of his game. Walking him down is Billstein. Less than a minute left in round number two. Which one of these men is going to move on?
I mean, the judges,
Abu Dhabi.
In the judges' eyes at the moment, Billstein is winning. The fight is weighted in his favor.
I haven't seen anything out of Martynov so far that would show me that he really has a lot of stopping power. He's not really throwing with any sort of intent unless he's holding back and just saving those power punches. But
yeah, and you get that other philosophy where the fighters, they're so worried about losing, they don't do anything to win. They're so worried about getting hit that they don't hit.
There's a
nice right.
Yeah.
Now he's unloading.
And that's the end of round number two. Was it too little, too late to take that round against Billstein, who has been very dominant, closing the distance and putting his opponent on the ground? It'll be a tough one for the judges to call as you're watching EFN 7, the Road to the King's Cup, and also right in the middle of the Road to Abu Dhabi, the lightweight and middleweight division.
And this will be an intriguing final round because hopefully Martynov took some confidence back to his corner at the end there with he only landed a few clean strikes, but that right hand was definitely effective.
No, it surely was.
And if he takes a bit of confidence back, right, his corner should be saying to you now, listen, you're down two rounds. This is the final round. If you want to win this and get to Abu Dhabi, you've got to change up a gear and pull something out of the bag.
That's what we'll see. We'll see what happens here. We'll see if there's any sort of urgency in the fighting style of Martynov. And it is third and final round coming at you here in the Road to Abu Dhabi middleweight quarterfinal. Yeah, when you talk about some of the guys that have moved on in this division, you got to look at a guy like a Christian Mapumbu, who had a nice victory, and he'd be a difficult one to deal with.
Yeah, and have a look at the how busy he is as a fighter.
No, exactly.
Upstairs, downstairs, all over the show, and powerful as well.
He'd have a huge size advantage over either one of these fighters.
Yeah. Yeah, range-wise and strength-wise as well.
Of course, we hope you're following along on social media at AD Warriors on Twitter and on Instagram. And, of course, follow us on our Facebook for all announcements concerning Abu Dhabi Warriors, our next big mega event, which is projected by the end of the year. So,
now
stay tuned for that.
Is Billstein just
trying to ride it out?
Exactly, trying to ride this round out, or is he wary now of moving in because of the right hand that landed at the end of the second round?
It appears that now he's going to try to close that distance and bring this thing back to the ground and possibly tick off a little bit more of the clock. Billstein doesn't seem to have any sort of intent on trying to finish the fight. Martynov, don't want to play around with him for too long. Just about the time we said he didn't seem like he had a whole lot of punching power, he showed us at the end of round two what exactly he possessed, and it was pretty impressive.
Yeah. And in a situation like this, it's not a life or death fight, but you'd like to see someone get some desperation in there and not be.
They all can't be Willie Ott, Grant.
No, maybe we were spoiled there. Bless him. Billstein just relentless. Go for this takedown.
Big strong frame there from Billstein. Big wide frame. Very hard to stop, but a great takedown defense by Martynov.
Martynov's got a sort of a bit of a guillotine there, but the referee stood him up, nothing happening.
Maybe conserving a little energy for the finals. That being said, you got to definitively win. We like to believe that Billstein is up in the cards, but nothing is set in stone. And we've seen crazier things with 2 minutes left here, round number three. Neither fighter really going in for the kill.
Yeah, you can't throw single shots at someone like Billstein. You've got to set it up.
When he has thrown combinations, it's worked.
cut the ring off. Use some ring control. He's got it. Martynov. He's got him in the corner a few times. Like now, step back. Keep pushing him. Keep going side to side. Trap him in the corner, as he did at the end of that second round. Like here. If he steps to his left, he can't move out there. You see, let him out there.
Billstein moving out of harm's way with just a minute to go. Martynov was appearing to really go after it there, but just couldn't connect on the combination. Now we're back to square one. Martynov and Billstein. Of course, the winner will move on against Umar Yankovsky. We'll move on in the tournament in November. Left. Are we going to see a little fireworks here at the end of the round? Any sort of urgency? And here we go, in the corner, but quickly Billstein smartly neutralizes the striking attack.
Yeah, approaching the last 10. We're not going to see a finish now. But it makes you wonder how Billstein would do against a different opponent. Interesting.
Good chance that we're going to find out that's the end of the round. So now we will go to the judges' scorecards and see who moves on in the Road to Abu Dhabi tournament. Here from Sofia, Bulgaria, the Armex Arena. Take a look at that replay, and Billstein just kind of stuck like glue on his opponent. Saw a lot of flashes from Martynov. I just don't believe he did enough. Looks like we have an official decision. We'll go into our MC, Grant Waterman.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of mixed martial arts action, we go to the judges' scorecards. And we have a unanimous decision in favor of your winner. From Germany, Jonas Billstein.
Well, no surprise there, Billstein did enough and played the game like it should be played. Smart move.